shall see it with their own eyes, his people. Amen. He has redeemed Jerusalem. The Lord will lay bare his holy hand in the sight of all the nations.
Bye. Bible said, as the deer panted for the waters, so my soul shall long after thee. And I'm not paying. Jai bibiamu, send your servants and the poor. Oh, coming out with the fiasino. The way they were praying and worshiping our Maker. And the gates open. Hallelujah. We are going to invoke His presence this morning. Open your mouth and worship Him. You don't need any music. You don't need any worship.
Thank you. please put your hands together if it's, as he comes up stage. Elder Gabriel Frimpong. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If he's not here, will you call on the praise and worship team again? Please prepare your offering and tithes ready. We will take our offering. And, oh, okay, Elder Frimpong is coming. Please put your hands together for him.
So this morning we are here to welcome our district pastor, Pastor Kofi Echampo, and the family. And for this reason, I want each and everyone here to give their maximum support about whatever we are doing here. And will you not left out with your gifts and everything you have to welcome the man of God and the family so that they will feel comfortable to work with us here. God bless you this morning for being here, and I know that God is in our midst and He is going to do great things before we depart from here. God bless you. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
So at this juncture, we call the praise team to lead us through tithe and offering.
Oh, Thank you. We thank you even for the opportunity, my Lord, you have given unto your people even to get wealth. This morning, whatever you brought, you gave to us, O God, a portion of it has been brought before you, my God. It's my prayer that, my God, may this sacrifice be acceptable before you this morning. Father, even as your people have been obedient unto you and brought it before you, it's my prayer, my God, that you bless your people according to your riches, O God. Father, I pray once again, my Lord, bless your people until your people become blessed. We thank you in Jesus' name. Amen.
The manager of the house welcomes you, then you know everything is okay. When I saw the ladies welcoming my papa, I said to myself, it is okay. Amen. And the men confirmed it. Amen. But it is imperative, therefore, that they verbalize this welcome. Amen. So without further ado, we'll call on the following groups to come and tell us or give us their welcome messages. We will start from the witness movement. Please, if I mention your name, come up stage. I'm a man of time, so if you delay a little bit, I will skip. So witness movement, right after that, children's movement, the women's movement, men's movement, and then we'll continue. So witness is coming, children's ministry, please be prepared, women's movement, you follow.
Hallelujah. Oh, sons of God. Oh, I cannot hear you. I said, sons of God. Victory. Dear Pastor Kofi Echako, greetings in the mighty and awesome name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Truly our God is a great God who continues to show himself faithful. God has demonstrated his faithfulness once again to the Virginia District of the Apostolic Church by blessing us with a new shepherd in accordance with his will. In Jeremiah chapter 3, the verse number 15, it says, and I will give you shepherds, quote unquote pastors, according to my heart, who shall feed you with knowledge and understanding. Let me take this opportunity to thank our Heavenly Father for allowing us today to gather together to welcome our new pastor who will be with us for the period that God had ordained. Hallelujah. On behalf of the District Witness Movement, we want to especially welcome you to the district. As you're well aware, the mission of the movement is to win souls and provide an enabling environment for spiritual, for professional, and for social growth for all our members. Hallelujah. The district leadership is committed to the mission, and we continually work with that focus in mind. Over the years, the movement has chalked laudable successes in the areas of spiritual development, soul winning, and we've celebrated many graduations at all levels of the educational ladder. That notwithstanding, the movement has also faced daunting challenges in recent times, such as youth suicidal tendencies, youth attrition from the church, and a general lack of commitment to youth activities. With your youthful zeal, with prayer, and with the energy that you exude, we see you as the perfect gift for the movement at this time. We look forward to enjoying your ministrations. I've enjoyed one already. Hallelujah. Your support, both spiritual and advice-wise, and we look for your encouragement to further the mission of the District Witness Movement. We recognize that due to our own youthful exuberance and sometimes our own peculiar characteristics, sometimes we may be heavy and sometimes we may prove a little bit of a challenge, hallelujah. But one thing we can assure you as Witness Movement is that we pledge our fullest support to work closely with you to accomplish the purpose of God for your life, for your family, and the church corporate, hallelujah. Feel free to tap into the vast treasure trove of our resourcefulness for church services, evangelism, prayer, and outreach programs. We are convinced that with your arrival in Virginia District of the Apostolic Church International USA, the District Witness Movement will not only see an upsurge in growth, but also a clear manifestation of God's power that will be etched on the pages of history. Being confident of this, that he who has begun a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Jesus Christ. Philippians chapter 1, verse 6. We can all agree that our Lord is at work to fulfill his agenda for the church in the United States. May I ask all the witness movement to stand with me? If you identify with the witness movement in the district, please stand on your feet as we clap our hands and we welcome our new pastor, Pastor Kofi Echampo. We want to welcome you. You're welcome to the district. We are here for you. Let's energize the base. Like that man out there, energize the base and then we move on in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you all in Jesus' name.
Children's ministry, women's movement, please be prepared right after children's ministry. You come upstage. The children's ministry is not ready, so women's movement, please come upstage. Thank you. Okay, the children's ministry is ready.
Amen.
Thank you.
Good morning, Pastor, and good morning, everybody. This morning, Pastor, we want to say that welcome, the children ministry, district ministry. We say that we are appreciative of everything you have done so far. We want to see you do more for us. We want to see your dedication. And we are definitely excited to have the kids as well. And mommy, we're excited that you've been there to help us in Sunday school as well. We pray that God will give you the strength that he has given you to start this journey. I pray that may he multiply it more and more. May they be abundance of blessings. Amen.
Crown, crown. Double crown, crown. We as a women's movement would like to send a message, not as a whole, but as per assembly. Because they want you to know how you mean to them. This is the Virginia Assembly. Dear Pastor Kofi Boete Echampo, we the executives and the entire members of the Apostolic Church Virginia Women's Movement sincerely welcome you and your family. Our hearts are open to the work with you in the Lord's vineyard. And we see that you are also ready to work with us and to take our church to a higher level with the help of God. Amen. Amen. It is our prayer that the good Lord who has called you will bless and strengthen you and also continue to direct you as to where to take our church. Amen.
Amen.
Ma Ivy, our mother, we love you so much and appreciate your occasional calls. They really help us a lot. So please go on. Again, we say Akwaba and God bless you all. Amen. Richmond also says, we thank God for the life of our pastor and family. They are very humble and loving. Good at interacting with people. Our biggest heartwarmer is their humility, a very great asset in leadership. Amen.
Amen.
Maryland, Pastor and Asafumami Ivy Echampo, we offer this special tribute to you for the faithfulness, love, and care you have demonstrated to each and every one of us, and we so much appreciate it. For this short time you have been with us, we honestly say that this is a man who has dedicated his life to the God and to the church. To God and to the church. We are confident that this is the beginning of a good work God is about to do in our midst, and we are patiently looking forward up to it. Amen. Akaba, Pastor, Ma Ivy, may you be the shepherd according to God's own heart, who will feed us with knowledge and understanding. Jeremiah 3:15. Amen. Now from the district, Akaba, Pastor, and Ma Ivy, We welcome you on behalf of the district executives with two hands wide open. All we want to say is, as Paul said in 1 Corinthians 3:6, I planted the seed, Apollos watered, but only God brings the growth or increase. We pray that God gives you the direction through the Holy Spirit to water the seed planted, so he will bring the increase. Amen.
Amen.
We know you highly respect all the women in the district by the love you show to the women's movement. God bless you. We are saying that looks as if either you are mama's pet or you were close to your mom. Because the way you sit closer to the women's movement, you don't really understand. It baffles us. And I know the other wings are jealous of us. But all we say is, behind every successful man is a woman. So still stick to us and we'll be successful. Amen.
Call the men's movement to give us their welcome message. The men's movement. Amen. Please put your hands together. Oh, man of God. Man of God. Is there any man in the house? Are we still sitting down? Oh, man of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Today is a wonderful and a beautiful day. Hallelujah.
Amen.
On behalf of men's ministry in the district, give honor to God, Son Jesus, and the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We also want to take this opportunity to welcome our Apostle, Doctor, and also for my Amen, Akufu. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Pastors, elders, friends, and visitors. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. On behalf of men's ministry, I indeed honored to welcome our district pastor and also Mame Echampon. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. We want you to know that we love you and your family, and we will support and honor you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We read our Numbers 14, 2 and 4. Hallelujah. When Moses was leading the Israelites, hallelujah, in a way, no, they will criticize Moses, hallelujah, and some people to discourage what assignment Moses, hallelujah, to lead them. Now, Moses stay on focus, hallelujah. Now, we now so here when I'm here, you might have one good group, but as a so hallelujah. Sana also from here can as a man in the district. Oberti and Sembibri or Asum, Oberti and Yamabibri, near here can I say, a man of him, Wabem, hallelujah. When I'm here, I'll throw any at my part, I saw on some, or don't ever have a group anyway. Hallelujah. Also, so I say, what kind? Jeremiah 3:15 na se ni ema ame eka e na e hono nso no o se the Lord says I will give you pasture according to my own heart which will feed you with knowledge and understanding. Hallelujah. Also for adwuma onyame ade ahye won sa no eye adwuma eye adwuma kesiye. Hallelujah. Na yeah, ma'am, I would be straight. Me a person, I catch you, I say, get your full support at our chief. Name, I'm say, would train me a radiant same near here to meet you now. A tomorrow, you bet me a poor man near our person watching you. This week, Mundia, who bet me a chief. Hallelujah. So, what time? Genesis 14, 14, 14. Genesis 14, 14. Okay, a bra. Our town for a quarter a lot, so a quarter one that was here, and one call, and who are so on. A son said, Moses, okay, can't join us, Moses,
Onua Agresi, 318 strong men in his family, hallelujah. No Jinaso Adi Koji Kwasuma Yede Unia Abako Eshimono. Sam or Sokosi Asafuimu, any district mu, sa wubuha na wu yire wan kasa u training a memma akukudru for best support to wa juma mua e juma na uye no e memma no ebe tini e jinemu ni ya puwao na ni ya uye biyansu no e yeye na ashe e radi edmonya hallelujah and on behalf of the men's movement ye di full support eta wenchi ni ya uye biyansi ye pese ye ye edi puwao no ye beri ye biya puwao na ashe na miye mwenye ya mwakaba kwenye edusmeni na amen.
Thank you. God bless you. We will move on. The next group is the district presbytery, after which the area pastor's wife will also bring us.
Men of God,
be strong in the Lord.
Sons of God,
march forward.
Good news.
Amen.
Amen. Apostles, pastors, elders, Malano, deacons, dignities, and distinguished guests, and saints in the Lord's vineyard, who have come from far and near to grace this important occasion, on behalf of the district presbytery, I say welcome and feel at ease to enjoy every minute of this service. Amen.
Amen.
All the world is at stake, and all men and women are merely prayers. They have their exits and their entrances, and each man in his time plays many parts. This quote from William Shakespeare, As You Like It. Providence has placed you in this great Virginia district to play your part. May success crown your efforts. Everyone hates or don't really welcome change or transfers because we are humans and we don't know what lies ahead of us. It takes courage to embrace change or transfers. However, we Christians do know that it's God who brings changes and transfers. He is the only one who knows and holds the future. He equips and protects whoever he calls or sends for his service. God will do the same to you because he has said he will never leave you nor forsake you. His presence will be with you as you walk faithfully with you. You have been called out of Worcester into Great Virginia District for a purpose and in a time like this, in the annals of the district, in God's own planning. Just as Queen Esther in the land of Susa, in Esther 4:14. You have been called to a congregation of various spiritual, emotional, and physical needs. However, he who has put you into this position will equip you with all resources you may need to accomplish this task. He will never put you to shame if you work faithfully with him. The district presbytery is standing with you throughout this journey. As Moses said to Joshua, David to Solomon, and God to his people, we, the district presbytery, are saying the same to you. Fear not, be courageous, and be like a man. Do the work for which God has placed in your hands, and continue the good works of your predecessors. Now into the district state which we come. New York is known as the Empire State, Delaware as the Fair State, Florida as the Sunshine State, and Virginia is for lovers. So we are continuing to come. Emotional and spiritual needs. God bless you, bless you and your family. All of us say welcome, your mama, Baba. Well, in John, born on the day. Amen.
First John chapter 4, verse 17.
Now I say, this is how love is made complete among us, so that we will have confidence on the day of judgment. In this world, we are like Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise God. And now we'll take the one from the USA area pastorate. On behalf of the USA area superintendent, Apostle Dr. Kwabena Daute Ekufu, who doubles as my spiritual father and mentor, and as well as yours, and the whole US area pastorate, I read the message to you. When Joshua replaced Moses and became the leader of the children of Israel, God provided him with a solid foundation of his divine promise to wield, and this enabled Joshua to succeed in his leadership endeavor, even in the face of troubled challenges. This promise, which can be found in Joshua 1, 3, and 5, reads, "Every place that the sole of your foot will tread upon, I have given to you. Just as I promised to Moses, no man shall be able to stand before you all the days of your life. Just as I was with Moses, so I will be with you. I will not leave you nor forsake you." We find this same solid scripture very appropriate for you and your family. We want you to know that God has already made available to you and your family all that you need to forge on, even in trying times. You have been called by the Lord to lead his flock in Virginia District. And his assurance to you is that he has given you the place that your feet is treading currently. He has promised never to leave you nor forsake you. And that no illegal authority of the enemy will be able to stand before you. We urge you to stand firm on this provided foundation and never turn to the left nor to the right. Remain focused. For the Lord is with you to direct, guard, guide, and lead you in the way which you should go, just as he prospered the steps of your predecessor. He will do same for you. Area pastors do welcome you to your new vineyard, affirming their support for you. May the Lord protect and provide for you, for your needs, and may he sustain you and brood over you and your entire family, and may he cause you to excel in all your deliberations for his glory
in the matchless name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
As we said, we are gathered from far and near. There are some that you don't even know their names, and there are some that you have never seen before. So without further ado, I'll call on my own brother, Steve Tete, to introduce the dignitaries among us. Amen. Please put your hands together as much as you can.
Give the Lord a mighty clap of it. Hallelujah. Amen. The way that the Lord said Virginia is for lovers, some of us will consider relocating. Hallelujah. Because it looks like where we are, there is no love. So stay tuned. Hallelujah. Give the Lord a mighty clap of it this morning. Amen. We have a few dignitaries we would like to introduce. First of all, we just want to thank everybody for coming from far and near. Everybody who is here, we bless you and we appreciate you taking time to be here this morning for this great occasion. So give yourself a round of applause for coming from far and near. Amen. We have with us this morning Nana Keja Ajimanjesi II. Let's receive him. Let's welcome him. With a mighty clap of Nana, you are welcome. Thank you very much. Amen. And then we have Nana Chubesi Dakun I and Kobia Hini of Ekropum Ekriapim. Let's give him a mighty clap of and welcome, sir. We appreciate you. Gamboy speaking to you. I think I did okay. Let me do it again. And Kobia Hini of Ekropum Ekriapim. And Kobia, you see, I told you, Gamboy. Hallelujah. Let's give him a round of applause. Welcome, sir. Amen. And we have with us this morning Pastor Paul Saba from Latebiokoshi District in Ghana. Pastor, let's receive him and let's welcome him. Hallelujah. Amen. I used to live in Latebiokoshi. They have the best rice and stew. So in case you go to Ghana, check out rice and stew from Latebiokoshi. Amen. And then we have coming all across from the West Coast. Somebody says West Coast. Pastor Ni Abolomote and Sofumami Pegilomote from Arizona, Chandler, Arizona Assembly. Oh, let's welcome them and give them a mighty clap of welcome. We appreciate you. Amen. And then we have our own Pastor Dan Kote and Sofumami Estakote, our new Atlantic Center Pastor. Let's give it up for Pastor Dan and Sofumami Estakote. Welcome, welcome, welcome. We welcome all of you. And we have our mommy and daddy here, so we will introduce them at the appropriate time. Thank you all for coming, and God bless you. Amen.
Amen. Steve Tete, we continue with the program. We will invite the Virginia Victory Voices to give us a song ministration, even as we prepare our hearts for the Word of God. Please put your hands together for them, even as they come up to you. Let's welcome Pastor Dan Porter, our secretary.
Church today officially. So all of us
Over the period that he has been here, all that you saw was just comedies. And it's now that the work is going to begin. Oh, hallelujah. And for such a work to begin, you need a word of encouragement. I remember when I was leaving and the farewell message that was given to me helped me so much. So, Kofi, I will advise you, take the welcome message. Because Apostle told me that Virginia will forget you, but God will never forget you. And it's so true. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. It's a serious matter. So when I called Apostle, he said, oh, yes, yes, I told you. But God will never forget his people. So I love messages that come to you on your wedding day, your anniversary day, any birthday, any celebration. When God speaks to you at that time, please take it serious. Amen. Because those words will carry you through. And the farewell message Apostle gave me was divine. Because I realized that God gave me that message to prepare me for the challenges. So when the challenges came, those words encouraged me. Amen. So if you take this word, and I promise you, it will carry you through. We are so blessed in the United States of America to have such a man to be our superintendent for just 2 years. Amen. And I did talk to you for just 2 years. But thank God he's still around and he's with us. Oh, amen. This man has imparted on our lives as pastors and has transformed us and trained us into maturity. He is so matured and so well-versed in the word of God, said that the experience and the quality of his message will take you very far. So church, Virginia Assembly, if you are privileged to have this man here today to minister to you the word of God, I pray that you open your heart to receive it. Amen. Because it's going to be a blessing for you and for generations unborn. You cannot quantify the impact that this word is going to have in your life. And this man, so soon and very soon, will be leaving his position as our superintendent, but he will still be with us as our mentor. He is somebody who brings people up and will never bring you down. And I love him so much. And I appreciate the fact that USA, we are privileged to have him here. He is not going to Ghana, he will be in US. Amen. And I strongly believe that not behind every successful man, but before every successful man. Oh, I want to say it again. It's not behind every successful man. It's before every successful man. Because if you don't have a wife going before you, amen. Mama Peggy, please be on your friend. Let us give you a rousing welcome. Church, let us welcome Mama Peggy Akufo, the wife of our superintendent. Hallelujah! Without much ado, with a standing ovation, let us welcome our superintendent, the one and only Apostle Dr. Babila Gaute Akufo. We are hands together for the Lord.
Praise God. God is good all the time. And all the time,
God is good.
When somebody gives you such an introduction, that you have to try and live up to that expectation, you know.
Say the youth know quite say so. Now if they are the swan up to any as a cell one more than say, send a youth who may do something so.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Pastor Dan is a great man of God, isn't he?
Amen. Yes, of penin down. Oh you mini packets here.
You are doing the work of God in my role as superintendent. You need men like that. Otherwise, you can't do that work.
Say, only me area Juma say or be our share and potemu hana. We near nipa and I say nami nipa sa and yes, I want to me near a Juma no.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So we thank the Lord for his life.
And then I say, Mana Brahma.
I'd like Pastor Dan and some minister to stand up for me for a moment.
Somebody in Islam, Brazil, now, you're in Soko Penny, and then you walk up for your Soko Mami, as a region now, so am I.
It's the pillars in the area.
Oh, my, in our area, you move.
And they have worked hard, tirelessly.
Now, I get a Juma to see it.
You can have vision, but if you have vision and you don't have the people that can support
and help you to implement that vision, it will not go anywhere.
The instrumental
and the things that we've accomplished in just 2 years. Has been instrumental. So church, let us celebrate the life of Pastor Damocles
today.
It gives me great honor to come here to Great Virginia, the only great assembly in the entire United States. But I know Richmond is challenging them. Maryland is also challenging them. So watch out, Virginia.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Let's bow our heads in prayer. Father, we thank you for the opportunity to hear your word. We ask that you speak to us, minister your word to us, touch us, give us a learning spirit to receive your word and apply in our lives, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Let's take our Bibles and open to Apostle Paul's letter to the church in Ephesus, chapter 4. We'll read verses 11 and 12.
Yeah, Friday, trust them, no. Amy, you call, or some of our poor woman, or Trocoma, as Safua, I want Ephesus, no. It's 8 and 9.
11 to 12.
It's in Timu, Duba, and it do me, no.
Ephesians chapter 4, 11 to 12.
Ebinom asetakafo, ebinom ahwefo, ene akyerekyerefo. Na watoto ahotofo yie.
Ama osu
ejuma no.
Ama Kristo ni pedia no.
Sie akosu.
Amen. And he himself gave some to be apostles, some prophets, some evangelists, some pastors and teachers, for the equipping of the saints for the ministry, the work of ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ. Amen.
Amen.
It's a fairly common passage that most ministers are very familiar with.
We trust a man as of four and as a man for any degree.
Today I want to minister to Pastor Fibuete Achiampon and some Mami Ivy Mamli Achiampon, and also to all ministers gathered here and all members of this district.
I'm not paying to say a chair as some way, and my sofo or fear champon, and the sofo my make of fear champon. Ne a sofo, I shame or heading out, ne a sorry to lean
out. Pastors manage the business of the church, they run meetings, they prepare sermons, they visit members at home and hospitals, they counsel members. They officiate weddings, baby dedications, funerals, all kinds of ceremonies.
And
as they get involved in doing all of these responsibilities of a pastor, sometimes they get so absorbed in it that both the pastor and the members may forget the real purpose for the pastor's work.
Now, so we are a juma we no, and my
Both the pastor and the members may forget the purpose of the pastoral work as a result.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And knowing this very well, God in His infinite wisdom and in His grace has written through the Apostle Paul to remind pastors and members of the real purpose of pastoral work.
And
so in spite of all of the things that a pastor does, all the nitty-gritties, all the chores and going and ups and down, Apostle Paul wants to remind you, Pastor Kofi Buete Achiambo, all pastors here, all members here, that the purpose of the pastor is to equip the saints for works of ministry and for edifying of the body of Christ.
And don't you know, also for Kofi Achiambo, Paul,
if you want to equip somebody, then you need to have the things to equip them with. And so the pastor has to make sure that he's equipping the saints with the character, with the skills, with the tools, with the talents for the members to be able to perform works of service, works of ministry in order to edify the body of Christ. But you cannot equip the members if you yourself don't have the things to equip the members with.
Praise
the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. You cannot give what you don't have. Let me say it again. You cannot give what you don't have. You cannot equip members with the development equipment unless you have that development equipment yourself. And therefore, as a pastor, Pastor Kofi Buete Achiambo in this district and all pastors, in order to be able to equip the members, you have to continually, aggressively equip yourself first.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Therefore, my message is, equip yourself in order to be able to equip the members.
And you see, as someone we didn't want to pay, they said, "Shall we then send a bear? Who bet me a share a story money then?"
Every now and then, when I go to visit Ghana, somebody will come to me, and then they will come and then put a case before me and say, "Pastor, can you get a visa for my child to come to the U.S.?"
Say, "Aya, na semo no okosla Ghana. Obi di asam ebe tu ne ni mosheso so peni."
You see, in Ghana, when you're a big man, you can go to passport office and get a passport for somebody. You can go to the ministries, you have influence. And so they come with the same attitude, and they think that I have visas in my suitcase that I can just be giving out to people.
Ghana dear, sir, oh yeah, in particular, and in Papeni or Utsmi Ra, a Bamu, a real remo. Now I could give this idea about a Lutino or Qua. Omohuno was our crying out, so Omoka said, oh no, I look to me now, and when the suitcase me, and the man said, oh, my teacher.
Praise the Lord. Boy, do I wish I had a suitcase of Jesus. I would grant everybody blessing of a green card today. Amen. But I pray that God will grant you a green card if you don't have one. Amen.
Amen. I can't say I'm going to send a suitcase. You know, this is in our room. I can't remember OBBRB. Now, in Pi, one says, oh, yeah, me, Emma, OBBRB.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
But because I don't have visas, I cannot give visas.
And I'm say only visa to want me and my visa.
I can't give what I don't have.
On to me and family only.
Turn to somebody and tell them you can't give what you don't have. If I come and I ask you for $1,000, and all you have is $200 on you, even if you desire to give me that $1,000, it is impossible for you to give me that $1,000 because you just don't have it.
If you say, "Nia na unni,"
you can't give what you don't have. Tell somebody you can't give what you don't have. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The Apostle James realized this when he was writing to the 12 tribes.
Now, Osomafo James, Yakubu, so Ehunye, and Unti Abrana or Trakoma Ebusuya Dumi, no, no, or Kase.
He asked the question of the 12 tribes in James 3:12. He says that, can a fig tree bear olives?
Now, Obisa said, fig tree, it makes me ask to olive Abana.
If you go to a fig tree and you keep looking for olives on a fig tree, there is no way you can find olives on a fig tree. The fig tree cannot give you olives. You can't give what you don't have.
If you say mango, to me so anka.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And so you have to make sure that you have something before you can even offer that something.
And until as I say, oh, no, now would you to say, oh, baby, and some away to me inside the crown of Amma.
Therefore, the corollary to this is that you can only give what you have.
And until you could see, I say,
tell somebody you can only give what you have.
And
that leads me to this account proverb that says, Patrikwasi obema untuma. You can't give what you don't have. And in English, we'll say, perhaps in an American way, if a homeless person says that he will give you a home, listen to his name, homeless person, and know that he doesn't have a home to be able to give. You can't give what you don't have. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Are you following me?
Otie.
And so, ministry is like that. You are called as a minister to equip the saints, according to our passage that we
read.
And you are to equip them so that they can perform works of service, works of ministry, in order to edify, that is, build up the body of Christ.
Now,
this passage is a passage that if all churches understand, then churches will be able to develop. Because it turns out that all too often, churches depend on the pastor to do the works of ministry. And somebody has said, a pastor-dependent church is a weak church. The pastor hasn't been called to do all the work, but he has been called to equip the saints so that they can perform the works of ministry. Are you following me?
Amen. Na nia okan nyina ne se senka nsori nyina asafo nyina ebeti nia okan ase a se onyame frɛ osofo ne se ommehye asori mane den se nia be ya wo be ye den na waye onyame osum adwuma no ye beti ase saa enka ema adwuma no enye den nia okan ne se asori a ono de debia ohye se nyame adwuma no sofo nko a ne be ye no eye asori a eye mere.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
When I was in an engineer in industry many years ago, I rose to a certain level and then they decided to promote me to be a manager to manage 10 engineers. And I protested. I said, I like doing this engineering work and I'll be more effective. But if I'm managing people, then I will not have time to do the engineering work. And you know what the director told me? He told me that if I am doing this engineering work by myself, I am accomplishing what one person can do. But if I become a manager of engineers and I'm able to equip them, train them, direct them, then I'll be able to expand my work to accomplish what 10 people should do.
Abrana owo wi ase eye adwuma ewo engineering mu no na adwuma ne ya de de yi.
I mean
na
me we urade fe
ne amekan wate ase e. Enye nyame adwuma na oyi de mu na oyi adwuma eye engineering. Na ne bi ji hu yie ba bia na owo no na odrun pempen so bi aye ma no ekɔ de nim se onkɔ hye engineers be ye edu so na o kan se nyame yie eye me de yie na me kɔ hye engineers edu so ami ntimi nye nyame yie. Na dear, or yet depending on catch the reception. So, over share engineers in Dusua, Niawo Yano, let's watch that's the Nipa in Duhamo Maya, Niawo Yano, so walk away and our own Yamako.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And God, in His infinite wisdom, even before modern management discovered this principle, wrote in our passage in Ephesians 4:11-12 that the purpose of the pastor, the purpose of his job, is not to do all the nitty-gritties of the job, but to equip the saints, to equip them, give them the development skill, the character, the tools, the talents, for them to be able to do works of ministry in order to edify the body of
Christ. Na onyame aka wɔn asɛm mu dada sɛ ɔsɔfoɔ no n'adwuma ne sɛ wobɛhyɛ members no anaasɛ asɔre ma ne den na watumi ayɛ onyame adwuma na ɛnyɛ sɛ ɔsɔfoɔ no nko a ɛbɛyɛ adwuma no nyinaa na mmom wohyɛ ne ɔmo den na ɔma yɛ ɔsom adwuma na ma onyame adwuma akɔ so ɛwɔ sɛ asɔre baako.
For those of you who like theology, I have put forward a theology that says that modern management is used in corporations. Originated from the Bible. You go in there, you see the principles in there. And unfortunately, we in the Christian world, we have pulled away from it, and the secular world have taken it, and they are using it to their advantage. The time has come for us to rise and embrace the modern management principles that is espoused by the Bible, equipping the saints for works of ministry.
Now, more, and I say, yeah, you pay on your me, I say, more in Suyadiano, was a share in Suyadia be said. If we ask you, Kurano, I dear you, on your me, I say, when I say, Mono, on your me, it's a share, Mono, or the by say, or the only pay or Shafosa or backstretch the Nipa, Nama, what to me, I call anyone so I stretch the Ebimono, if we ask a craft, I dear you, Juma, now on your me, say, Mono, now on your me, I say, to one another, and son, I hear you, you won't be Kurano, Ebayanusa.
And Jesus, when he walked this earth, he followed this particular strategy for running the church.
Now, on your copon, and I say, yes, na now, no more of the two we are seeing, or these signs, say, Beya, or Debeya, or Yami Etuma.
He selected 12 people and he named them apostles.
Offer any patum, you know, now offer almost say, Asuma for.
And then he equipped them. And if you go to Matthew chapter 10 verse 1, the Bible says that he gave them authority to heal the sick and cast out demons.
Now come at you, say, pa, it's a bako to chemuduna. Or say, oh, my one to me, so one to two, I are a bonnet, now one say, I are a
one. And then he commissioned them to go on an evangelism work.
Now, say, what shall one say, one could we are sick, now one could cancel, pa.
To heal the sick and cure all the disease and then bring deliverance to those who are possessed by demons.
So on kona on kosa ya re na won so ampotre agye won no won ji won enfiri mu na won fa fa wodi emre won.
And then in the instructions that he was giving them at the end of that instructions in Matthew 10:8, he told them, freely you have received, freely give.
Na ni a ose won ensese ya odi ma won no e won Matthew sempa etire ba ko tete mu etire du tete mu won twere se mwa no kwa enu ti no mon fa o san ye den e ma kwa.
You cannot give what you don't have.
Won to me e ma ni a won ni.
You can only give what you have.
Ni a won kwa na wo betu bi ya.
Jesus gave the apostles the authority to perform healing and deliverance, and now they had it, and he told them, freely give what you have received. You can only give what you don't have. That is why my message is, you must, Pastor Kofi Buate Achiampo, aggressively equip yourself in order to be able to equip the members of this church.
Now, yes, you express me for the say, after my mouth to me, some moon sign, and I want to do. Now, moon need nothing or the mawn or can say, send me a media mamma panel, moon yellow sound, moon fire mapa, and also your software example. And I'll pay you with a Yasama, the day my one is said. And send over to me, I'm my baby, no, and bring piano and water so she said, when I'm me and you, now when I'm in my baby, now wait to me at Yama.
May God equip you with power and authority to be able to equip the saints. And may God empower you, the saints, to be able to receive the equipment from your pastor.
In fact,
this principle was demonstrated in the life of Peter and John. When they were going to the temple and they arrived at the gate called Beautiful. When they arrived at that gate, there was a cripple there who was asking for money. And so the cripple was looking at them with the expectation that they would give him some money. Peter and John, when Peter looked at the cripple, he looked at the cripple in a certain way. I don't know what the cripple was sensing, but maybe that cripple was sensing that Peter was about to give him lots of money the way in which he was staring at it.
Na senior na John ni Peter e kwano obubu ani ni shero na Peter so shero kwan bi so e no tiri e ma obubu ani ni yesa senior papa e hwe mi die e mi se obi yisi ka kesie mi pa dia mama.
Then Peter told him, silver and gold have I none. I don't have any money, and what I don't have I cannot give you. What you don't have you can't give.
O ka tere ni se sika ni jite die mi ni bi.
What you have is what you can give. You can ask Peter and John from Kingdom Come to give you money. They don't have any money. They can't give you. If the pastor doesn't have the equipment to equip the saints can sit at his feet for 1,000 years and he can't equip them. And unfortunately, there are some ministers that are that way. Today, I'm here to encourage you, Pastor Kofi Buate Achiampo. Equip yourself in order to be able to equip the saints.
And I'm a pain in the neck. I show the day so for Kofi Achiampo. And they say, say, members, they know, so went to me and show them what they are. Next, they say, well, I'm not going to say, so we'll share what they are. And not to me too, for no matter who cries, say, but what they are saying, I pray now, oh, my show, what they say, I will be to me, I shall members and also they.
And then listen to what Peter said.
See, Peter can't.
Peter told the cripple, but what I have, what I possess, what I've been equipped with by Jesus Christ, what God has endowed me with, the anointing that breaks loose upon my life, the character and the skills that I've been given. That is what I give to you. Therefore, in the name of Jesus,
yes,
and the authority of the Holy Ghost, rise up and walk. Rise up and walk. What I have is what I can give. I cannot give what I don't have.
you don't have, and therefore I must get what I want to get. Oh, somebody glorify the Lord. You can't give what you don't have.
Well,
tell somebody, you can't give what you don't have. You know, and it may seem to you that this is a message for Pastor Kofi Boateng Achampong, but it is not. It's a message for you. It is a life principle in your life. You, as a parent, you cannot give to your children what you don't have unless you equip yourself. You, as a husband, you cannot give to your wife what you don't have unless you equip yourself. You, as a wife, you cannot give what you don't have unless you equip yourself. In fact, many marital problems are because both husband and wife don't have the thing that they need to give in their marriage. You can't give what you don't have.
Ebi anopai ebeo se asimwe ekoma asofo champion ni yirepe nemo mo no eya abrabom nsheye nsem se oye oba ana se oye awofo ni awuni no wutumi fa mawoma se oye okuru ni awuni wutumi fa mawoye se oye oyere ni awuni wutumi fa mawokuru empo enemi awarem nsem bebere ba yesisi no ni ayisisu ni se ebi a okuru ni ni se so de mawoye oyere ni ni se so de mawokuru and no na akofa o how bebere apa awarem.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Sometimes I'm troubled by people who just want position. They just want a title.
Aya.
But you don't have to be able to give. And you just want a title. And maybe that works in a secular world. But in the spiritual world that we are operating, if you don't have it and you go and occupy that position, you can't give. And because you can't give, you'll be in spiritual trouble.
Nah, and I no pay me person me catch up. I am not have me baby. So we be over or pick the piano. Now so the piano to me no only. Na se wa nhye ye na se wodi anu achi na wokojina dibia no na woni dibia ne mutumi a honhom no na wakofa o how bebere e dia power kasa wo so.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So as a pastor,
this is so for
you must aggressively
as a say awode
so continually
na abren na
equip yourself
with
the equipment that you are going to equip the saints with.
What if I show
you? Because there's no way you can give what you don't have. You can only give what you have. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And in the Matthew 10:8 verse that I cited, freely give. Freely give. Because freely you have received.
And until Matthew 7, it's a good thing. What you are kind of, or say, Fama keke, send me a win yano keke.
That word receive there, if you go into the Greek, also means take. It either means receive or take. And in a context where this verse occurs, it is properly translated into the word receive. But in the original language, it means both receive or take.
Na se wo call Greek is your dear one. In church, the mono ASA woo chick, and until no sepia, yet church the mono ever profuma, and yo say, Wooden young qua, demo Greek cassa the mono dear, and church the mono is a woo chick, and after woo sign and ya, what day man our sign and ya.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let me say it in English again, maybe it will come out. And so, what the verse is trying to say is that you receive by taking. And so it is not a passive thing. When I say freely you have received, it's as if you're sitting down and then without doing anything, somebody comes and gives you something. But the connotation of the passage there, the word received there, really means receive by taking. It is an aggressive act. Are you following me?
I know you know. Say castle when ya no chase what's massy akawa out or so. Now I bet all na so. Nemo mono wahum na walk casa why then what's one about na walk of fat.
Every now and then my wife will carry a nice bag and some of the women will come, oh so mamma for a bag he mammy me for. And then every now and then she will gift the bag to them. And so today when we're kind of asking her, are you gonna give this bag away? And she said, as for this bag, it's not going anywhere.
Yeah, so for mommy. ne ba de no e ma ba wa ne hu a o se so ma me we die e ye me fe fa ma me e no ti a no pe ne ba no e fe pa obi sa me se we so o de be ma na o se na we die me fa ma
ba ke ne so se mu ba no bi sa de so mpa ba ge na ma mo
ti se wa ye wa ti ne so e o be die a e ne die ne so ma me so mpa ma o
ya me ka na ku ma no fa ba ge ne che obi e de e wo yesu di ma Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
But you know, what the women are doing is that they go to her and they ask for it.
Yeah.
When they ask for it, the way in which they ask persistently, she gives to them, so they receive it. Are you following me?
I don't think near my bow why say, well, a choir of Faso Episanentino. Let's just say, all this of my mother was upon the old to me, because there be no man as I said, or the mouth, now the mouth.
And so, this passage, this verse that I read, freely you have received, is an active, aggressive act where you are supposed to ask. And I believe that if we had known all the details here, the apostles did not just sit and Jesus said, I give you that authority. That, but they may have gone to him and said, Jesus, just as you are able to heal, and you are able to cure, and you are able to cast out demons, we also want to be able to do that. Give us, so that we can have that authority to do that. And then Jesus said, receive it, I give it to you.
And not to say, let's see here, and I say, let's see here, and it's a tribunal. A swear for no aunt, Nassi, now Yesu, I can say, me, I can say, what's now when I'm in the mammo. Now when you are doing so, as you say, I will be saying, now I'm quite our fast, so she beside it, you know. Yes, so can say, send your mother beside you, to me, Munje, I'm in the mammo.
And so it is an aggressive act. Go boldly and you ask for the thing and you receive it.
Look, you will be silent and more daily and near day. So the Napsan prayer will be silent.
That is why Jesus said, the kingdom of God suffers violence and the violence take it by force. You don't stand idle and wait for it, but you go and you take it. You take whatever is there and you use it. That is why I'm here to encourage you. You must by force equip yourself, you must take it for yourself. Empower yourself and do not be able to equip the same.
And it's a Bible, you know, you have some echoes of flying here, and you have more than any addition and addition, and until South Pine and Nano pay so for as a sour fossil, what the end near day, and Tia would be feeling a cup on chain, now a shower would day, send your bay also went to be your members in
the
day.
Therefore, the members also are speaking to you that you must aggressively go and take from him. So that you can perform works of ministry in order to edify the body of Christ.
Sorry, man, so no. It's just a mode and yet they entry a free chain. Send you away a moment to me, shamo holding my year on a mere juma.
Because you can't give what you don't have.
You send me, I won't need no good to me, farmer.
You can only give what you have. If you have $1,000, you can give it.
So I pay.
If you have $200, you cannot give $1,000. If you're a mango tree, you cannot give an orange.
So we are mango, I want to me a man car.
And if you're an orange tree, you cannot give a mango.
So as we are car, I want to me a man.
You can only give what you have. You can't give what you don't have.
Who to me man you won't need.
Therefore, you must equip yourself, Pastor Kofi Boateng.
Yes, I will show what they so for Kofi Champon.
Get all the equipment.
Now we are accepting
the character, the skills, the
talent,
that you'll be able to impart to the church here.
And
if you continually equip yourself, you will be much in success. May God equip you.
Now let's show to equip the saints.
May God empower you.
May
God be able to empower the saints. May God give you authority. Authorize the saints. The saints, may God give you the spirit to be able to receive from your pastor.
May God
progress Great Virginia Assembly to become a Greater Virginia Assembly.
Virginia Assembly,
may his peace be upon this assembly. Upon this assembly.
Oh my God.
sound praise. That was a wonderful performance. Amen. I think you're on our list to be invited to Arizona. This performance, we have to fly to Arizona. Amen. Before we continue the program, we want to acknowledge the following dignitaries that just joined us. The first on the list is the Virginia Omahini, that is Nana Ajimani. Amen. Please be upstanding or give us a wave. God bless you for coming. We also have here Nana Akwesi Akuaku Mensa. Amen. God bless you for coming. And we have Nana Hima Tina, that is the Queen Mother of Azim, Aguna Traditional Area. Amen. You are welcome. Thank you for gracing the occasion with your presence. Amen. Now we got into a very pivotal part of the program, that is the induction service. Without further ado, I will invite the area superintendent and the sector head again. Please put your hands together, even as they take over.
Scriptures are our sufficient and final authority in all matters of doctrine and practice. Do you pledge, by the grace of God, to discharge your duties as district pastor in accordance with Scripture? Do you reaffirm your belief in the fundamental doctrines of the Christian faith as contained in the tenets of the Apostolic Church. Do you approve the worship, discipline, and government of the Apostolic Church, promising always directly and indirectly to support and promote those doctrines? If you do so, respond.
Yes, I do.
Amen. This time we'll ask you to kneel down, your wife first. My friend, oh
says he is my shield, my rod, and my song. Amen.
Amen. Thank you.
and in the interest of time, when you are called, no speech is placed. Just come and drop your envelope and sit down so we can finish on time. So I'm going to set the ball rolling by first inviting the area administration to present their gifts. You just come and drop it in and sit down. So area administration, and Steve will do that for us. Amen. Elder John Mensah, and then he's going to invite the various groups. So immediately he calls your name, just drop your envelope and please sit down. After which, Elder Simon Kofi will take care of the individual gifts.
Hallelujah. Amen. Just like Pastor Alomote rightly said, you have presented your gifts, your messages already. So now when we call you, you just bring your presence. So at this moment, we will call. If there are any churches here, I've received a check from Syracuse District already. So if there are any churches here that are not in our district, and you have any present, any gifts for Pastor Kofi Achampo and the family, you can raise your hand if there are any gifts from outside Virginia District. We've received one from Syracuse already. Arizona, put your hands together for Arizona. Amen.
That's a very young assembly, just opened recently, and they have come to support Pastor. God bless you.
Our presiding elder once said, that in Ghana, when we are doing this, you will see somebody carrying a plantain, a TV, or chain, whatever they brought from their district. But here in America, we have everything at Costco. We have J&J in Woodbridge. You can go there and get your plantain. So we need cash, your check. If you bought a TV, great. We also have our credit card machines. Amen. So if you don't have your checks, you see Sister Patricia, I'm patient. I'm going in at the reception. If you have your card, we will take it. She will give us the receipt and we will transfer it to Pastor accordingly. So now, if you we don't have any churches here from outside Virginia, just like we did with the messages, you are coming but you are not presenting your message. You bring your present, and we are going to do this by district. So we will call the Children's Ministry, Virginia District Children's Ministry, if they are ready to bring their present. Bring their present. God bless you. Amen. We will move on to the Witness Movement. Virginia District Witness Movement. Virginia District Witness Movement. You gave a beautiful message. We hope your check is beautiful too. Amen. He said it's beautiful. God bless you. Amen. We will call our mothers. Oh, hallelujah. You also gave a wonderful message that behind every successful woman, a man is a woman. And to make him more successful, we need money. Amen. God bless our mothers. Amen. That's Virginia District Women's Leader, Mama Getty Kwashi. Amen. Amen. God bless you, Mama Getty. Now we will call the men of God. Oh, men of God. Oh, strong with the ISM Matimokasi, no check it on. Men of God. Men of God. I hope your check is strong. The King Cancer, God bless you. That is the men's movement. Now we have some departments. We don't have them by the district, but they alerted me that they want to also present. So I will ask humbly, so that we will call the ushering department to come and present. We don't have a district ushering department, but they have their presence. Sister Patience Amwakonhe, she is presenting for the ushering department. Amen. They are the only department that have an account. Oh, finance department, we don't have an account yet, so we don't have any money in our accounts. But Pastor, we'll make sure we get to you. Amen. I think that is all. If there is any movement that we didn't call, we've called the children. So we'll call the district presbytery. You'll come later. The check must be very big. Yeah, not ready yet. We have hand days. Hand day. But we can't have a hand day civic. That's a hand up.
Honda Civic KGL 4030. Please, somebody is going to work. You've blocked the person. And a Toyota 4Runner KM. Delaware District, amen. Oh, put your hands together for Delaware, amen. That is from the Delaware District. Thank you, God bless you. Virginia District is not ready yet. Amen.
Amen. Thank you very much, Elder. We will call on Elder Simon Kofi to take the individual gifts. Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Usher said, Pachau, you are every to be saved. You hear me, be our man is a special emblem. Special emblem for special occasion. Hallelujah. But my husband, how much check do you want to? Pachau, who are you? Okay. Bible says, give and it shall be given unto you. Give and it shall be given unto you back. Amen. Good measure. Hallelujah. We are coming to give to support the man of God. Hallelujah. I am not here to call for any appeal, but I want you to pray over your gifts. And I'm telling you, from here, you are going to be huge. Say amen. Amen. Are we ready? Write your name and your phone number so that a pastor can call you. Shrouding.
is not in, we can't continue without your mic. You want to? I need to move on to one. Amen. Oh, okay.
Oh, hallelujah. Amen. Amen. On behalf of District Presbytery, we are here on behalf of the whole district to present our gift for our pastor and the family, our pastor Kofi Echampong and the family. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you very much, District Presbytery. Thank you. We'll do the presentation very soon, but before that, I want to take administration from the dance ministry. So please put your hands together as the dance ministry takes the floor and prepare the gifts for presentation. Dance ministry, please.
My world is you right now. My world. Free, money ni nye adwuma no money yen enye adwuma no money ya ko bi shi ra pa and America na se asori tuoni ni na wo money mbo rich money ya ta wasi wo money mbo obi bia wo bia si ya me bi shi ra mo Virginia the great Central ya se ya me bi shi ra mo odo a modernity of Virginia has seen that yes, issue and in Shrapa Central Yami in Shrapa Yawin and Yami in Shrapa Committee and organizing welcome service. We say God richly bless you. Amen. A new webinar, I was a tremendous thing, I was a presiding and a senior, almost a put me together and ten ten. Now, if you a moment, we be a queen. Yes, committee ni presiding and the senior and the senior presidency in our committee ni as it yami in shall pa. I feel when you say war a year district, you know, women's movement, children, men, witness. Yes, yes, in shall. Baby, yami, and the more baby drew, you better amati, a year pia, I'm a German, according to you, pa. We say God richly bless you all. And the Obi Bia Swa Owa Hansi. Ye bet that ye nana omu esu asi. Omu ye membe Swa Hansi, but omu me tro omu di. Abelu. Adibia ye bia ye no omu ne ye. E ni tu omu ba, omu ba omu omu fi. Abelu. Omu ye omu ye nzema ye na.
Steve.
Parcels that you want to give to our pastor. So please bring the parcels now. You can come and drop it off right here. If your parcel is ready, please come and drop it off here as we take our announcements from, that is the district, and local announcement from Elder John Mensah. All parcels, please bring them together. Parcels, parcels, parcels. Thank you. God bless you. Any other parcel, please bring the parcels together. Parcels. Okay, thank you. And we also know this is the United States of America. Some of us are paid bi-weekly. So probably your money wasn't ready today. Next week, you can bring it and we will take it. Amen. So we pray ahead of time for those who will bring their money next week. In Jesus' name, may they be blessed mightily. Amen. Now let's invite Elder John Mensah to give us our local and district announcement.
Own people would like to do their own presentation for Pastor Kofi Achampo and the family. Hallelujah. That is from the junior youth. So I will stand in for the junior youth as their elder and present this beautiful surprise present to Pastor Kofi Achampo and Osofo Mami Ivy Mamli Achampo. That's from the junior youth. I have no idea they were doing this. Hallelujah. They always do that. Oh, amen. Amen. And they also have this beautiful card for you from the junior youth. God bless you. Now I'll hand them over to the MC.
Wait after church service in their seat to be served, we will be served. Amen. A quick correction in your program with regards to the venue for the men's, area men's movement convention.
Dancing on the upward way, new heights of day, every day.
just 1 minute to make this announcement. Today, our message is that you cannot give what you don't have. Ni awuni no wunzi twa maoba. Sa wunye baiboni ya uba njumye baiboni. Sa wunye jidini ya uba njumye jidini. E shase di Amerika ya kumwa. E mebo konvenshe yi ya koswa fra ya kumwa. Ne ya swama ya ma. Ma omodachi. Ushanyama El Kosuna. Jerusa in the next 10 years. Yeah, El Kosuna America. And until Mango Convention of Yada Matuno. Yeah, Bompaya will see 1 year. Yeah, for a young woman. You cannot give what you don't have. 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 5. Paul, come to Timothy, say, I am reminded of your sincere faith, which first lived in your grandmother and also lived in your mother, and I'm persuaded lives in you. It is near a what Timothy, my grandmother, Muno, and I'm not my name, and then my Timothy, and I'm not your grandchild. What do you mean, so for many years? Yet, not as a kiss, you have one pious say. Yet, you know, my man, send him a yard. That's it, your retirement is never good here. You're a little bit of a convention. So we are going to pray to our children. Send them Louis Bombay. Not even you, Miss Titi, Timothy. Not even you, Osuma Fokesiano. And now we are going to be able to get the money. You cannot give what you don't have. Who did you hear? Who did you know about you? Who did you mean? Who did you mean? Okay, amen. Islam in Nara. And your convention, I am Obi. Uba or one bow is up to you. A man who should actually be. Oh, man, when there is an opportunity for you to speak into the future of your children, Paul says, and then you are bringing us down here in Cambridge. That I was so weird in Yamen. That I was so weird in Yamen. Now, even we have Yasasi. I'm Pobra Yasasi. I don't know if we have said Yamen yet. And look at us a weird in Yamen. I'm losing our way like I said Yamen. And then you are bringing us down Cambridge. Would even we have to work as I said? But to report your one name. Now we send you away, we have a great big impact. The bombire and every Wakua will see a chump. Let you all say, Sarah, you may be letting that guy. And so the bombire said, I'm going to be Piara and then you need a little bit of Sima virtue. The Samoan man, Mamas of Yehua. So Wakua, you are Brazil and Mamua, Famsun or Kassa, and you two are Tampa Crew. Now, Tampa, you're not emotional. Now I'm free and Johnny. Now the genius, sorry, and Peter. Now I'm calling him to come. I want Jesus Christ. Father, you want to pray about my shimmy. But I will not pray, I will say, I don't even pray what is a true man. And I listen to a man. How to the moon I have said, yes, to the young man. Now that should be, like I said, yes, I am so much of you. But I am going to be able to get me. But I am. I am going to be able to get the money. I want Jesus in the name. Amen. 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 Amen.